I'm enjoying watching that Stephen King thing, that 8 hours of Stephen King.
Oh, if you started, I was going to wait till the weekend.
It's good. Somebody sent you an advanced copy, Robin?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Now, who sent that to you? Like a listener?
Uh-huh.
Wow. I wonder why he sent it to you.
Because I was the one who was making a lot of noise about it.
Oh, so he wanted you to...
Yeah.
Let me see. I don't like when people send good stuff to you.
Well, you never share, so...
That's true.
I didn't bother to tell you. I don't know how you found out.
I do share. No, you're obnoxious to say that.
You don't share at
you're
all.
A little hoarder.
Oh!
If
hurts,
I get something, if I get something, I have to... I tell Robin, I have to make sure... I always go to Gary, make sure everybody sees this, pass it around.
Oh.
And Robin's like, well, then I just hide it in my apartment.
Gary must not tell anybody.
And Gary is another little weasel.
Know.
You have no idea how much Gary annoys me. He's supposed to be my producer.
Uh-huh.
And I'm supposed to know everything that goes on. And I said to Gary, hey, you've been watching that Stephen King thing. It's pretty good. Oh, I saw the whole thing. I go, you saw the whole thing? Like, why would somebody want you, Gary, to see the whole thing? I'm the guy who talks on the radio. I can spread the word about it.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, I seen the whole thing because Robin got it. And she gave it to me. I said, wait a second. You knew Robin had it? You should give it to me.
Oh, he should give you my stuff?
He should tell me immediately and let me have it. And
he didn't know. It was sent in my mail.
Why
he didn't get it.
Why didn't he make a copy of it for me so I can watch it?
Yeah?
Well,
because he's a nitwit.
Know.
That's why.
That's your producer.
Baba because he's...
Take
Baba
that up
I'll tell you something. That's my producer. You know, I get more production out of Ralph, who tapes stuff for me and plays it and keeps his eyes open for me. Gary never comes in here with a tape and goes, hey, I taped something last night. It's wild. We could use this on the show. He's a worthless nitwit. He gets me so annoyed when he just opens his mouth. What are you doing in here? I threw you out. That's precisely why you annoy me. That is the best example of why you annoy
First
me.
First of all, I always bring you stuff.
Hey, maybe both would need to see this.
I always bring you stuff.
No, you don't. You don't bring me anything. You
That's
only bring me stuff that is in my mail.
I tape stuff for you all the time.
When have you done that?
Let me see.
Yeah.
I taped the Saturday Night Live, even though you didn't need it, but I've taped a bunch of TV news reports.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, gee,
you
no
just don't know
what...
Knows. Well, you wouldn't know.
So how was how did you like the how did you enjoy the entire Stephen King presentation?
I was a little disappointed with the ending.
Oh really? Okay, good. Get the hell out of here.
What are you getting mad at me for?
Get out of here. Because you know why I'm mad at you? Because you don't even know why I'm mad at you. That's why I'm mad at you. Because you don't think for me.
Why don't you? But what about Robin? Robin's got.
Robin
right
is. Robin should. Robin. I just call Robin a filthy little hoarder.
Oh, okay. All right.
And now I am telling you.
I'll take my list.
I am telling you that I can't stand you. That's all. Goodbye. That's it. That's it. You don't think of Wolf. That is your problem. You only think of Gary. How you can go out at night on my name. How you can go and get tickets on my name. How you can make your job as fun as possible.
Yeah, I don't
but
do
I
any
need
work.
You, I need you.
I don't
to
do
think,
any work. Do
you
I?
Don't. Because you don't think of Wolf. And you don't think of the show.
No, not much at all.
You're sitting there with a tape. Roll a tape for me. Make a copy. Make it easy
I
for me.
I didn't really
to
want
function.
To see it.
Okay. Very good. I haven't been talking about it on the air, have I? Do you listen to the show?
No.
Uh-huh.
The host annoys me.
Oh, good. Robin's got something I need. I'll go get it.
Yeah?
That's he's good at. I bet she ran over to your apartment to get it.
He did.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Go ahead. Go produce. Do whatever it is you do for me.
You've been a mean human being lately.
That's right.
A
get
very
out.
Mean human being.
Out. Get out.
It's all
out.
Over. Everyone's out. Been talking about it.
Good.
The
out.
Editor's faxing in. Mean.
Yeah, and I'm going to be even meaner if you stay in here.
Well, I really don't appreciate you calling me names because you do whore. You keep everything to yourself.
Yes.
It's always, yes, I saw this, I saw that.
No, what's going
to
happen
I'll
is...
I'll bring it to you.
No.
Yeah,
you,
one of these days I'll show you.
In a year and a half, all of yous will get to see everything because I'll be gone.
Fine.
That's it.
I have shared with you for 13
it's okay.
years.
It's okay.
But
it's okay.
If one time somebody sends me something and I took it home.
Actually, you are pretty good at sharing.
Pretty good.
You actually do bring in a lot of cool stuff. I'm mad at Filthy Smelly Mouth.
Yeah, divert. You called me a filthy hoarder.
A filthy little hoarder.
After all I've done, this is the gratitude.
You see how easy I turn? How
this
quickly?
Is the gratitude, I guess. I'm constantly thinking, you didn't tell me about Saturday Night Live. You don't tell me anything.
I didn't tell me about Saturday Night Live. I was sleeping through it. Anyway. Let's put that behind us.
No, you really riled me.
Oh.
I've done so much. I always try. I'm always thinking.
You know what the motto is, Robin?
What?
You can never do enough for me.
Well, that's it.
That's...
The road has ended. It's cut off.
She's the one who didn't tell me about that she had the whole copy, and now she's cutting off the road. All right, two can play that game.
You never tell me anything anyway. It won't make
You're waking people up.
Different. That's what my job is.
War.
How dare you?
Let me get back to Letterman because no one wants to hear this.
No.
You can take that up with me later.
Oh,
please.
I can't talk to you anymore.
You'll get over it.
I won't.
Now, where was I? You'll have to get over it.
No, I can't. That hurts.
Oh. It's all right. We got 4 hours. More will hurt when I get done. I'm crying over here. So listen to this. Letterman moves to Los Angeles. This is why we have to move our show. That's why we're broadcasting from Los Angeles today. Letterman moves his show to Los Angeles. Now, again, I'm at a loss because I haven't seen... Robin has seen the whole week already in advance, but I haven't seen anything.
Of Letterman. I don't have time to do that.
You saw the whole week in advance?
I know the whole lineup for the week.
No, I thought you saw all the shows already.
They don't do the
Letterman. Oh, I see. Okay. Anyway...
But he did call me with the lineup.
He did. He wanted you to see that. So listen to this. Papa Fooey really annoys me. You got to just keep him out of the room.
Papa Fooey
just annoys me. Why is it Ralph knows I'd want to see that, but Papa Fooey doesn't? Tell
Papa
me that.
Fooey.
I don't know.
Okay. Anyway, listen to this, Robin. In Los Angeles, what is that?
I have the answer to that.
Yeah, let me hear.
Ralph has all day to sit at home and cater to your every whim.
Oh, and you don't.
You're
so
working.
Busy. I see. What are you busy working? I see why you're work. He makes a phone call. It's work.
Are you unhappy with the guest lineup on the show?
Am I unhappy with it? No. Why would I be unhappy with it?
Are you unhappy with my work? Do you think I don't do enough?
Yes, I don't think you do enough.
Well, that goes without saying. Is there anyone on the show that you
just asked me a question. Well, I said yes.
Is there anyone on the show that you think does enough?
Yes.
Who?
Robin, Jackie, and Fred.
I don't believe you.
You're absolutely
wrong.
Right
behind their backs.
Tell me what it is that Robin doesn't do on the show.
Jackie doesn't want to work on weekends.
Jackie doesn't want to work on weekends. I don't want to work on weekends.
You
know, why would Jackie want to work on weekends?
Sometimes when you've had things for him to do on weekends, you've screamed and yelled that he won't take a project home and work on it.
You're dreaming.
I'm not dreaming. You've said
you're
it
dreaming.
A million times.
What is this? What is this? Embarrass Howard now? Get out of my studio, you friggin' hairy, toothless jerk.
Am I fired?
He's got these little nubs underneath
his teeth.
I'm an idiot. Get out, and you're fired.
Idiot.
Pack up your bags. Basically, now he's going to drive a wall between me and Jackie and Fred and you. That stupid, smelly, no-talent, toothless jerk.
To tear apart the whole organization.
He's got big, white, fake teeth. He's going to sit there and tell me what I do and don't do.
I'll work on weekends if I have to.
Yeah.
If I have to.
As if what he does is the same as you, Jackie, and Fred. He thinks he's right up there in the same ballpark. I could replace him tomorrow. I wouldn't miss a beat. He thinks he's the same as you. That's what kills me most about him. He thinks he's as valuable to the show as you are. That's crazy. I could throw him out a window, and you and I could sit and still do the show. He could be replaced with a guy with one finger.
He could be replaced on his way down.
I mean, who is this guy? How did I get so attached to him? Why doesn't he go? Why doesn't he go work on another show? I mean, this guy's nuts.
Well, it did cross my mind as he was coming to pick those up that I don't have time to watch this band this week. But he was rushing to bring my house together.
How is it he has time? You know he watched two. He watched 4 hours last night.
Wait a second.
He watched 4 hours last night. He's so busy.
3 hours.
3 hours.
Without commercials, it's 90 minutes.
Oh, I got to fast forward.
Wait a second. Robin doesn't have time to watch anything because she's writing the story of her life.
Yes, so?
Yeah.
So that's her choice.
Yes.
That has nothing to do with this show. She wouldn't be writing the story of her life if she didn't
have,
this show.
I still have to work on this show.
Nobody on
the
show would have anything if they didn't have this show.
Gary, you had 4 hours to watch TV yesterday.
3 hours.
How can you tell me you're busy working? What time did you get home yesterday?
I got home at about 2:45.
2:45?
Yeah.
You did?
Yes.
You stayed here till 2:45?
No, I was here till about 2:50.
Oh, so you stayed here until 10:50.
Right. Then I went over to Robin's.
What'd you do? Did you go to the Friars or
nothing? No, I didn't do
anything.
No, I don't go to the Friars.
You don't?
Jackie.
I thought you go a lot.
Jackie, roughly, how many times do I turn down going... How many times do I go to the Friars?
Where'd you go last night? Did you go out last night?
Of course not.
No. Well, that's an unusual, that's a rare night where Baba Booey isn't out on the town.
I haven't been out on the town in a long time.
All right, listen, it's just, listen, you're fine. You're doing a good job. You're annoying me today. That's all because you're sitting in that chair. Anyone who will be sitting in that chair.
This is me. Wait a minute. This is the best.
You're annoying me. That's all. You're just annoying me.
What, you know what he said?
What?
He said he wanted my copies because he was tired of fast-forwarding through the friggin' commercials.
Oh.
Listen, Queen Latifah, Queen Quivers, I mean, come on. You are the most pampered person in the world.
All right, go ahead.
You
know what? You're taking me off track. I'm really not into doing a Gary show.
It's not my idea. Every time I walk out, you get back on that track.
All right. Leave the room. He's something else. He's got a defense for everything. God love him.
The commercials were annoying him, so he wanted my copy.
Not to change the subject too much, but did you find a tape on your desk today?
No.
You know the guy who did the nigger-hating hat?
Yeah.
He sent another parody yesterday. I didn't listen to it. I just gave it to Tobin. The guy sent it to me because he was scared it would get sidetracked if he sent it to Gary. I guess it's a parody called Having My Monkey.
Where is it? I want to see it.
I left it with Tobin.
But why haven't I heard it?
Because I left it with Tobin just
as I was walking
out.
Did she give it to Scott?
I'm not sure.
What's with her? She can't give the...
No, it was just yesterday I was walking out, so it's not...
Having my monkey? Okay, here's the... as long as we're doing Gary, where is my new song parody?
Did Scott give it to you? He may have walked in.
The guy from... here it is. The guy from Crash Test Dummies.
I know all about it.
The guy from Crash Test Dummies has put together a song about Gary. Okay. Some new verses to that song.
All right.
What are you doing in here?
I thought you might want me to be here.
No, I don't want you to be here. I asked you to leave.
You sure you don't want to see the grief on my face?
No,
when you play it?
Let me just play the retard song. This is about Gary having a baby.
All right.
All right.
I'm about to provide you with an unlimited source of comedy for the coming years.
All right.
I have a big announcement.
Go ahead.
Oh.
Mrs. Bowie and I are going to have a baby boy.
Oh!
There was a moron. His name was Fafa Fui, and he looks like a baboon. He's got huge smelly choppers. One night, he climbed on top of his white wife.
Fafa Flunky.
They're gonna have a baby. Sure hope it ain't a retard. Retard.
Well, we're following doctor's orders.
Hey, even if the baby's retarded, it'll still be smarter than Gary.
Well, this baby boy. Have humongous teeth and bleeding stinky gums, and well, it'd be half human. Ape boy, I'll bet it looks like the missing link.
I'm an idiot. I'm a friggin' idiot.
It'll probably have fleas and peel bananas with its toes.
I don't know.
Ta-ta to thee, ta-ta to thee, fool.
Oh, this song calms me down.
It doesn't.
Ta-ta to thee, ta-ta to thee.
Get that out of all my anger.
For Gary's wife, we are glad. Just pray the kid won't look like dad.
I can't do it. I'm too stupid.
Why this greasy flunky thinks he has a right to have a little baby, and if it is a daughter, will she have big green caps and a mustache?
I thought smelly.
Very strange genetics when dad looks like cheetah. Ma-ma-monkey.
Everyone sing along. Ma-ma-monkey.
Ma-ma-monkey. Ma-ma-monkey.
Work the standard 9 to 5 hours. you know, usually leave here around 2:30 or so. At 3 o'clock, you know, I'll be able to pick the baby up from daycare.
Right.
And I'll be able to spend some quality time with the child.
Right.
And influence it. Oh, dear.
Mary, you want spaghetti again for dinner?
Honey, could you stop at the store and pick up some ground beef?
On your way home from work,
would you like Floppy Joe or Beefaroni?
All right, very good. The Fa-Fa-Fohi song. See, now I'm not mad at him anymore.
Oh, that's good.
I actually feel bad for him. Well, there he is, the crash test dummy. Actually, that's, once again, checking in with a great performance, Pat Godwin, who did a nice job on that.
Oh, boy.
And Fred Norris throwing in some Baba Booey sound effects and conversation. And
vicious talk.
Yes. That's the Crash Test Monkeys with Pat Godwin.
No.
All right, Gary, you can come back in. I'm not mad at you. It actually just calmed me down.
Yeah, took everything out of you.
Yeah, yeah, just mellowed me out. I come in a very foul mood.
Pressure's up.
All right, man, you're okay now. How you like your song?
I'm deeply hurt. I really am.
As you should be.
Not at the song.
No, I know. Well, the song is just icing on the cake.
Right, right. I'm more hurt at hating me for existing.
No, not for existing. For not thinking. That's all. It's not the person on the outside I hate. It's the person on the inside that really annoys me. You see what I'm saying? Don't get me. We're done. It's over.
All right.
It's over with. Forget about it.
Do you love me?
Yes. Absolutely.
I love you, boo.
I know. Gary's at a very vulnerable stage. You know, his wife is having a baby and, you know.
You're really tugging at him.
No prospects for the future. You know what I mean? It's just it's
he
bleak.
Needs How can you say that? Ever.
You know, I mean, you know.
What are you working on?
Well, anyway.
I'm going to leave because...
All right, go ahead.
Thank you.
Your kid has a better resume than you. Gary does a very good job. Gary does. Good. All right.
Gary.
Hey, repeat after me, Gary.
I
will never accept gifts...
Will never accept gifts...
That are really for Volfa...
That are really for Volfa...
That are glom behind Volfa's back...
That I will glom behind Volfa's back...
I will return the thousands of dollars of stuff.
Will return the thousands of dollars of stuff.
I have glommed over the years.
I have glommed over the years.
And I will answer the phone, Howard Stern Show.
And I will answer the phone, Howard Stern Show.
And not accept free crap.
And not accept free crap.
I will keep me.
Keep me
and my elephant teeth
and my elephant teeth
out of Volfa's face.
Out of Volfa's face.
Right, who else can I be mean to?
Smelly.
I still have a little venom left. By 7 o'clock, it should all burn off.
Like fog.
Yeah,
morning,
<it's> like, morning fog of New York. Yeah. It like hangs over the city.
The sun comes up, burns it off.
And where's our general manager, Tom? This should be directed at him. I hate Tom. Tom is to me represents what like a Nazi private would be. When they had the Nazi army, what was it?
The Luftwaffe.
Yeah.
Just following orders.
Yeah, he just wanted. I didn't know what I was doing. He's a guy to me who follows orders.
Yeah,
doesn't think
know,
on his own.
He would take the butt.
Good morning,
rifle.
Tom. Good morning, Tom.
And
how are you?
Jump somebody into an oven.
Yeah.
Because,
and he'll
know,
say, hey,
one more person could fit.
In retrospect, and Tom would be afterwards.
Was,
in retrospect,
I was kind of waiting for you to get to me.
I don't know. I need to direct this at somebody. See, Tom would be like. Hey, I had a, at the time, now in retrospect, I know what I did was wrong. Hitting the guy in the head with a shovel and throwing him into an oven was wrong. But at the time, everyone was doing it. It seemed appropriate. The Jews, after all, had been sucking Germany dry. You know, I believed all that, and I did it, and I'm wrong.
Up.
And now I've turned over a new leaf. And you know, I did what I was told, and it wasn't like I orchestrated
I've
this
I've escaped
thing.
To Argentina, right. And I'm living a good life.
You know, and I have pangs of guilt, but I got to go on with my life, right. And that's it.
Got to live.
Yeah, got to live.
Everybody's got to live.
You have something of a conscience, but listen, you got to go on. What are you going to do, kill yourself?
Look, I'm 82 years old now.
Yeah, right. You're just playing golf, and I'm relaxing. If Dan Quayle asked you to play golf, would you go? All right. You think about that, and I want your answer in the 9 o'clock hour.
Right.
Who's going to keep score? How dare you? That's my general manager. All right, Tom. Yeah, go ahead. I'm done with you. I'm all the venom has burned out of me.
Oh, good.
All right.
Okay.
The fog is lifting. Garibald's cheese. What?
Do you love me?
Do you still love me? Tom, getting off a good one.
6 years. Once every 6 years.
Like a Vulcan. All right, very good.